Hi everyone, Gabrielle here, my human tribe. So for this week's blog post, I chose an article that was released by CNN on December 30th that talks about the link of increased opioid deaths, 85% in this case, and automotive closures in certain areas. They use a term called death of despair. That really struck me. But it makes complete sense that if you don't have a meaningful way to feed your family and to live, that you might fall into depression, reach for drugs and alcohol, in this case, for opiates. And as a result, we have a death of despair. So the question then becomes, what are we going to do about it? And we cannot rely on governments to do for us, because they just don't. I mean, you can look around, you know, what happens? Not much. I also have a not-for-profit organization called Blue Red U. It's been sitting idle for a couple of years, but we had several things that we wanted to do. And one was alternative energy infrastructure builds across the United States and also vocational job training. Both of those would really help many communities that are currently afflicted by these automotive closures, for example, and other plant closures, manufacturing plants and what have you. So what I would like to do is to really invite everyone to read this article and then chime in. Get on my Facebook page, Instagram, my personal page, and just tell me what your ideas might be and how we as a community can change the trajectory so that we don't read articles that talk about death of despair. Everyone deserves to have a great life. And it is up to us to come together. I have a term called self-actualizing. So we need to self-actualize to take care of ourselves and our community to create opportunities. Thank you so much for watching and reading and following me. And I'll be back soon with more. Lots of love, Gabrielle, my human tribe. Bye.